Alright guys, welcome back to another Sanctuary vlog and starting the day off today at the vet. We're at the vet right now with the baby emus and we're just getting them a basic checkup, but also the real reason is we're trying to do a blood test to determine the gender of the two so we can have an emu gender reveal party. But yeah, so we won't have results for probably a couple weeks though. But yeah, we're here getting these guys checked out. They're very not happy about being in the carrier. It was a nightmare on the drive over, but you know, we're here now, we're doing it. So we're also here with Bubbles, one of our Peking ducks, who has really swollen, are those knees?
Joints.
I guess joints, you know? Having a really hard time walking. This is our second or third time at the vet for this specific thing with the duck. We've been doing injections. Doesn't seem to be working, so we just did an x-ray.
And you can see the joints over here. It's just swollen and not really well-defined. And so, yeah, he has a really progressed, like, infection in the joints. So we did x-rays today. We are going to try to culture this and see if we could find out what it is and what antibiotics to use. And unfortunately, there's no guarantee that this is going to work. And if it doesn't work, then it's a issue of quality of life.
So they might recommend euthanizing him.
Which is really sad.
Really sad.
So we're gonna try. I mean, it's about $400 to $500, but
yeah.
We're gonna do a fundraiser. We're gonna try.
We're gonna have to do some fundraising or something to try to help him out. I mean, it's just sucks.
You know, has to be put under anesthesia. You know, we have to aspirate it, but we're gonna do it.
Oh, vet care is so expensive, and yeah, I know there's gonna be haters and be like, "That's a duck people eat. Why don't you just cook it?" You know, you're gonna spend $500 on a duck that costs like, you know, $30 that you should just cook and eat. It's like,
we're a sanctuary.
We're gonna do our best to try to save him. You know, we think he deserves a chance, you know, a shot at life, and we're gonna do our best to and pay a lot of money to try to save him. So we'll be doing some fundraising for him. All right, so now we're back home collecting all the bulls. So I'm getting the quaddy bulls right now. So I just locked the stealing the ropes. We got little things to notch him on, but just didn't do it fast enough.
Should we hang the fly trap over here?
Yeah.
You want me to go get it?
What's that?
You want me to go get it?
Yeah, well, why don't you explain it, you know?
Yeah, so we just get, you know, flies. Not that there's like a ton of extra food.
Well, that's what we're doing right now. This is the inside of the lockout, so I'm cleaning up. They like to poop in here while they're eating.
Yeah, so every day, you know, we clean this out, but we do like to leave, like, you know, the monkey biscuits and stuff because they kind of snack throughout the day. But there's just, you know, lots of flies. It's really annoying. So we're going to put, like, a fly trap that somebody got us off of our Amazon wish list. So thank you. I know a lot of people ask for like the link and everything. We actually just posted our wish list yesterday on Facebook and everything was purchased. So thank you so much to every single person that got something. You can kind of like check periodically. Sometimes throughout the week, I kind of put one or two things on there, but usually we announce on our rescue page, Florida as well as Animal Rescue on Facebook. That's where we like post the link once a week. And if it's empty, that means that everybody bought stuff. So we have a lot of goodies coming this week, lots of freeze-dried raw Stella and Chewies for the quaddies and the foxes and some freeze-dried fish and some little snacks and a new hide. So we got a lot of good things. I also added some cooling mats. So I'm going to try those with the quaddies for the summer. It's going to just like help them stay cool. And for the foxes too.
All right, now we got a bunch of greens for Jumanji. Gotta make you stop to breathe, man. Man, he just chows down. Look at those little legs. All right, now we got all the tortoises eating. Got those two over there. You guys gonna come over? Yeah. Look at the way they're looking like, what? What? I'm missing the party? Alright, now we're in here with the goats and the pigs. Oh, Petunia getting aggressive, as usual. You want that Kit Kat? Yeah. Here, Petunia, you want this? Oh, quit being bad. There, have some celery. Hi, Julie. Petunia's demanding something. Hold on, I'm trying to open this. Don't bite me. Do you want any greens? Yeah, goats like greens. Here, go over there. Here you go, Tony. Oh, you have an apple? Whole apple. You want an apple, Julie? You sit? Julie? Good girl. Daisy's sitting. Here, you want an apple? Oh. Our apple, yeah, you can go pig. Hi, Kit Kat. I don't think you want an apple, do you? You want one. I don't think you want that. Ow. Kit Kat, quit kicking me with your one peg leg right in the nuts. Ow, gosh. It's like you got a magnet on there. And you sit, Julie? Oh, well, let's go pick Julie. Kit Kat, you are just crazy. What, you want this? You can't even eat that. Come on, Kit Kat. Here. You can have any of that. Go eat all that somewhere else, away from me. You want some of this, Petunia? You want greens? Here's a whole artichoke. You sit, Petunia. Petunia then suddenly charged me, attacked me, knocked the phone out of my hand, and I had to literally wrestle down on the ground with this pig. So the phone was facing down, but you can hear the audio. So as Petunia's trying to swipe me with the tusks, I literally have to wrestle him down and sit on him, which he does not like. Basically, I just have to hold him down until he stops trying to kill me, and then I can gently get off and let him go. Well, Petunia just attacked me. So that was awful. Literally, like, flip him over and sit on him for, like, the last 5 minutes. sitting here trying to feed him and be nice and just randomly just attack me. All right, now we're in here feeding the foxes. Oh my God, look at Hazel. Hazel, you psycho. So Kira's down there in the log eating, Yui's over here. So she's eating some ground quail right now. So they've got quail, chicken breast, exotic canine diet, peas, carrots, and what is that? Some spinach in there too, and apple. Oh my goodness. Hazel is being crazy. Hazel! It's okay, Yue. She was eating when I was turning around. As soon as I turned around, she ran off with it. Hazel, why are you so psycho? Here, we'll feed you now, okay? Quit being so crazy. All right, so Gabby's helping me film now, so you can see they're separated. They're eating on their own. Hazel was being super crazy, but seems like she's calmed down now that she's got her food. She was jumping up at him before, so she's testing.
He's not gonna let that happen, though. Chippo? Oh, it's okay. I'm glad to see him eating.
Yeah.
How are these girls doing? Hi, you guys are okay. Hi, Yue. You gonna eat your veggies? Looks like they ate all the chicken. You left all the veggies. We had chicken and quail today, and veggies and fruits, a little bit of wet food, a little bit of kibble.
All right, so now we're going to feed the quaddies. You want to list what they got?
Oh, pretty simple today. Just, you know, roasted sweet potatoes, some chicken, different kinds of fruit, papaya, some veggies, a little bit of venison kibble.
Gotta fix this.
Yeah. When they're locked up, we can just try to do a light scrub. And then we can let them out and see if they like their little yogurt parfait. Oh my goodness, you guys are crazy. Look at Blanco. Blanco. Record them from the outside. Oh, Lily is hungry today. She ran right over.
Looks so cute and adorable.
Oh yeah, cute and adorable.
Come on, they do little cute squeaks. How bad can it be? Bean! There you go, Bean. So Jelly Bean's getting blueberries, got blueberry, strawberry, pear, apple, peach, grape, peas and carrots. All he cares about is blueberries. Yes, I know. I see you, Petrie. We're getting you next, okay? There you go, Petrie. Got some blueberry. So Petrie is a red-billed hornbill, and he's the one that we caught flying around wild. So he's an escape or release or something like that, but yeah, he's flying around wild. Well, I'll take the camera to focus. Here's Rocky, about to flip his bowl over. Hi, Rocky. And Bluebird. Hi, Blue. Hi, Cupid. Hi, Cupid. Not a thought between those ears. Cupid Doopy. Oh, you looking at your bowl? Is it too far? Oh, there you go. Got some sweet potato. Chloe, you eating some sweet potato too? Yeah? All right, prairie dog time. Look at him sitting on his butt. You can come over, it's okay. This is like solid construction. Okay, hi, yes. I'm trying to talk about this, but yeah. So this is like really solid. It's not like the rest of the, I mean, this is like regular dirt, you know, and then like they compacted this in where like, you like it's like really solid. It's poppy. He's so crazy. Ah, Poppy. Poppy's trying to climb me. There. Hi, Poppy.
Come here, Poppy. I'll give you attention.
There.
I give you all the attention, Poppy.
There you go. Anyways, that's crazy. How did you do that? Just from the regular dirt. Just headbutting the crap out of it.
Poppy's living life. The cheeky.
There you go. Right now, we're feeding the small parrots. These cute little guys. Oh, literally just got landing on the phone. So they've got some sweet potato, some of the seed mix that we make, and then also a chop mix that Gabby also made. Candy keeps on landing on top of the phone. Just wants pets. I got the other one on top of the phone. Oh my goodness. You guys are crazy. All right, so now I'm in here deep cleaning the quaddy. So I just took all their houses down. I just sprayed everything down, soak it, and then now we're gonna go ahead and put bleach down. Let that soak in for a minute. And then scrub it. And then spray it again. Get this thing nice and clean. Look at that already. Now just scrubbing everything. Yeah, these
these ones are really stuck on there. Very glamorous work, guys. Right, so finished cleaning everything, got it all done. We got Lola. Hi, Loli. Hi, baby. We got her out here. Your claws are so sharp. So what we got for her, well, we got for everybody, but I'm going to let her get first dibs, are some like frozen yogurt and fruit parfait, basically. So froze that all together. It's been sitting up there thawing for a minute, so they at least have a chance. But you got to come up here. You got to see what we got for you. I know I'm filthy and probably smell very interesting. Hi, baby. Hi, baby. Oh, this baby. Can I pick you up? You gonna let me? Can I pick you up? No? Nope. You don't want to be picked up. I'm trying to show you. There's good stuff up here. There's good stuff up here. Here. You want to sit on my foot? Go ahead. Look at this. Ugh. Look over there. Oh, there it is. Okay. What is that, huh? Oh, what is that? Is that the best thing you've ever tasted? So because the Quaddies, the five of them, have basically split into two factions, I want to give Lola some time by herself, and then I'll let Lily out since those two get along, but I can't be in here with Lily, and then we'll let the other three out. That way Lola and Lily get some time to check these out and enjoy them, and they won't possibly be able to eat the entire thing by themselves, and then the other three can come out and they can get some time too. But Lola is very excited, and she really likes me, so I can sit in here with her, no problem. I can't do that with Lily, though, so that's why it's going to be Lola, then Lola and Lily, and then all of them. All right, so we let everybody out now, and nobody has seemed to notice the little frozen fruit parfaits over there except for Lola. So they'll find them eventually, though, but we're going to move on to the next thing now. Emu bath time. There it is. All right, so we've got the big baby emu, and this is gonna be the emu enclosure. If you didn't see us talk about this before, so do the wide angle so you can actually see. So this is the actual emu enclosure, and the big baby is just about big enough to not be able to get out. So the fence is right there at that line. Now the little one just went right through it, no problem. But we're pretty much almost able to contain this one in here. So that's pretty cool. They're gonna spend most of their time out free ranging anyways, but we do need to be able to contain them when necessary. So this is coming along. All right, so now we're over here doing some planning. So we're talking about putting the cavy enclosure right here and just having it so it would be right across from the coatis right here and having it right there as a 20 by 20, which is the same size as what Jet has over there. So that's what we're talking about doing and having it right here underneath this nice big tree. So we'd have to clear this out a little bit. It's just a bunch of smaller sable palms, really easy. So we can clear that out some and have it right here. And the coatis are being crazy.
That's Lola fighting with her sister.
Okay, come on. Enough drama. That's just a lot of drama and tweaking. Bam, you're not impressing anybody. No one is intimidated by you, Bam. Just a lot of squeaking, a lot of yelling.
Why?
So Georgia showed up. Hey, you guys remember him? So right now we are over here setting up the pump. We're probably gonna want to move that more. So this turned green like in the last 2 days. Like literally 2 days ago I looked at it and you know, it wasn't as clean and clear as it was when we went swimming, but it didn't look like that, so it turned green real fast. So we're gonna go and start up the pump and get this thing draining some.
Let's go, bring it in, no, that to the other side between the trees. There you go. Let's go.
Help me!
Oh my god. All right. Let's keep it going. There you go.
Woo! Oh, that looks scary.
You feel like a fireman?
Yeah.
Because that pretty much filled up this pond already. We don't overflow it, so now we got it out here. All right, so now me and George are kind of building the fire, getting a bunch of brush out of the way, so kind of getting this going, but I almost forgot I had these in my pocket. So we had a lot of awesome people order things for the sanctuary off our Amazon wish list. Shout out to everybody who does. I lose most of these little carts, okay? So I'm gonna name off the ones I had in my pocket. I lose most of them. So if you did buy something and I don't thank you, I'm so sorry. Thank you so much, but I lose these things all day. So anyways, we're also being serenaded by Olaf in the background. Beautiful sound. So thank you to Tanya Abbott. Get another one from Tanya Abbott. Hope the animals enjoy from Jill Dunbar. And then enjoy your gift from Rose Labar. And then we have one from Lori Reed. And then Tanya Abbott again. So thank you so much to everybody. I know I lose these things all the time. I'm so sorry for people who did buy things off the wish list and I don't personally thank you. I try to do this whenever I remember I have these things, but I lose them all the time. We're gonna add some more things to our wish list this week as well. And when I do post them, they go really quick. So I get a lot of comments like, oh, it's empty. That's because a lot of people, we have really awesome supporters and they do typically buy things out like almost immediately when we post it. So, which is awesome. Yeah, so that's why it's often empty as well. But yeah, so we're gonna thank you to everybody who helped us out and we're gonna get back to work on dragging some more brush and clearing some more path out here.
Hi, Sami. Here you go. Here.
Oh, there you go. So she's got sweet potato, pepper, carrot, spinach, peas, carrots, and what else is this?
whatever these are. Was that turnip? Something like that. Yeah. And strawberry. We got your peppers. Oh, we got peppers. You love peppers. No? Not good enough? Which one are you going to get? The strawberries, maybe? Oh, a little pea. A little pea.
Oh, you won't play. Oh, you won't play. Oh, you won't play. Oh, ho, ho, ho.
There you go, Jet. Here, come here. There you go, buddy. So he's got rabbit, an egg, some of the venison, exotic canine, blueberry, carrot, pea, apple, sweet potato. But he's actually more interested in, he knows George is over there. He can smell you, George. And so can I. No, I'm kidding. But yeah, so he's actually more interested in looking at George than the food right now. Come here, buddy. No? You know, you're scared of George? Yeah. All right, we'll just leave him with his food then.